This is a video that I've been wanting to make for quite some time since I partnered with Sonic Youth. Today I'm going to be reviewing a speaker that really blew my mind. This is by far one of the best speakers that I've ever reviewed, the best sounding speakers that I've ever reviewed, and I think they're mind blowing. So welcome everyone to my video on the Sonic Youth Reference Series StudioPod BHD speakers. That's right, I said speakers, because there's two of them, and they're both freaking awesome. You're going to want to check this video out. Alright, these right here are the Sonic Youth Reference Series StudioPod VHD, as you can see right here. And I've tested it, and they're amazing. The unboxing process is fairly simple. You open the box, there is a separate, tinier box that has all your accessories in it. So among the accessories that comes with your speakers are the RCA to 3.5mm jack. It comes with, obviously, the power cable. Comes with a 63 watt power brick. It comes also with an RCA to RCA audio cable. Now this is the cable that is required to connect between the active speaker and the passive speaker. So yes, this has an active and passive speaker mode, so I'll tell you about that later. Obviously it also comes with a digital optical cable for a more direct connection, a better, more seamless, less latency mode. So yeah, in Bluetooth there'll be more latency compared to directly connecting it to with the digital optical cable. So as soon as I unbox this guy, I noticed that this thing is really well built. It's solid covering of the speaker. It's like, it's really good quality as well. You got your metal grills, and since this is the active speaker, it has most of the main controls on the back. So among the controls you've got your volume, you got your treble, your bass, obviously you got your on, your input and equalizer button, as well as the line in button for left and right. And obviously you got an input for your coaxial cable, but so for the coaxial cable it's not included for this speaker, but if you have one for yourself you can use it as well. You got your power input and also the digital input, and obviously the speaker output, which is what that's required to connect between this speaker, the active one, and the passive speaker. For the passive speaker, you got nothing much at the port for the air to enter and get out, and also the speaker input. So that's basically it for the passive speaker. Another thing that I forgot to mention, it also comes with a remote. So most of the controls that you can do in the back of here, you can also do through here. I think the only thing that's missing is the bass and treble, but the rest, like the volume, skip between track, pause and play, everything else you can use to the controller provided. And yes, they've provided batteries for the controller as well, which is, love that. So how do these speakers sound? They are very, very amazing. They are 80 watt speakers, which, yes, I know, not that big, not that amazing, but considering the size of these speakers, they really pack a punch. And I mean, they pack a punch. Connecting. That's a nice sound. Wow. I was brighter, but I'm sure not cutter in this chain. Hear me, but these are amazing. Oh, they sound so good. Like the bass is so clean. It's so clean. Oof. By the way, the volume is at 25%. And I mean, right now it's lower than that, but just now it's at 25% and we're so loud. Oh my god. Alright, we gotta test this out. Like, you know, copyright music. That's right. This is the only channel that probably does that. Let's listen to some God of War, shall we? Oh, listening to the audio of the game. This is just the audio. This is just the music for the game. I can't imagine how it would be like gaming with these. I'm gonna try it out. Among all the speakers that I've reviewed recently, these are the loudest. Like, I can feel the ground shaking. Usually it's the table. I can feel the ground shaking. Oh my god. Let's go with something a little bit more from my town.
Days later.
Yeah, these are amazing speakers. Oh my god. Yo, Sonic Gear. Good stuff. Good stuff. I like this. I like this a lot. If I had a choice between really good headphones and really good speakers, I pick the headphones. I just like that personal experience. But the StudioPod VHDs have changed my mind. Literally. Oh my god. There's a particular sound that it doesn't show, so I'm curious this one. Yeah. So obviously these guys are marketed as sort of like your desk speakers. Although in the name it does mention that it is the reference series for Sonic Gear, but it doesn't really replaces your reference, your studio reference speaker. These aren't to be confused with that, according to Sonic Gear. They told me to mention this. So they mainly use the term reference series to point out that these are the highest end speakers that Sonic Gear sells. And honestly, they can kind of work in a studio environment. Well, in a budget studio environment. Because trust me, there are very high-end speakers out there that are way better for a studio experience. But this guy right here, for a normal, average consumer, amazing. So another thing that I gotta mention, that these guys come with four different colors. It comes with black, red, pink, turquoise, well, mint or turquoise, and they come in white. I'm not gonna lie, I really like the red one and the black one. Kind of wish they sent me one of those, but hey, white looks pretty clean, not gonna lie. So where can you usually use this? Well, I'm not sure if I mentioned this. This also has Bluetooth 5.0, by the way. So you can connect it to multiple devices as well. So you can use this in a desk setup sort of a scenario, or you can put it on a bookshelf if you want to listen to music while you're relaxing. Another thing that I tried out, and this is something I tried out recently, this is the only speakers that are kind of able to beat my current entertainment unit sound system. Trust me, I don't have a proper sound system. It's just the TV speakers. I noticed that watching movies with this speaker is just wow. I mean, I've tested a lot of speakers throughout my channel. You can go check those videos out. Most of them by Sonic Gear, obviously. These are by far the best cinematic experience. It really gives you a literal home theater like experience, if you get what I mean. Hell yes! These speakers are amazing. Back to the review, I guess. Considering that each of these have 4-inch full-range bass drivers in each of the speakers, they really pack a punch. Like, I was surprised when I first checked it out. And obviously, if you're using it for a movie experience, there are also some settings that you can input. There's movie, there's music, and there's dialogue. You can adjust based on your preference. Whatever you want, the options right here. So this right here are in the 599 ringgit price range. So within this price range of all the speakers that I've seen, that I've kind of tried out, these are very close to the top. And do I recommend you getting this? Most definitely. It's actually, it recently got released in Sonic Youth's website, because previously it was sold out in their website. So right now they've restocked it. You can go check it out yourself. It's not gonna lie, it's worth your money, in my opinion, in the $500 to $600 price range. So if you want to get one for yourselves, I'll leave a link in the description. Go check them out yourselves. So yeah, I guess that's all I gotta say about the Sonic Gear Reference Series Studio Pod VHD speakers. Wow, they really have a really long name. You know what? I'm just gonna call them Studio Pod. Yeah, I like the name Studio Pod. Kind of a riff with AirPods, you know? Like, if Apple were to make speakers, I mean, they have the color, right? It really matches with the AirPods, just saying. So yeah, thank you, Sonic Gear, for sponsoring me this amazing speakers. I really love them very much. I've been using them quite often, and they are amazing speakers. So yeah, keep making awesome products, and please let me review them. So guys, thank you guys for watching. Obviously, don't forget to leave a like and a comment down below on what you think are best home entertainment speakers, or music specifically, speakers specifically for music. So if you think there are better speakers out there for me to review, let me know. Maybe I'll go check them out. And if you want to see my other audio-related devices or other tech reviews or other Sonic Gear products that I've reviewed a significant amount of Sonic Gear speakers, so you can go check those videos out. The link will be in the description. The playlist will be at the end of the video. You can go check them out yourselves. And obviously, don't forget to leave a like, a comment down below, and obviously subscribe, because that's the only way that it's going to help me progress and make better videos in the future. So currently, as this video is out, I've already surpassed 300 subscribers. I'd like to thank you guys for that. Thank you so much. We're slowly getting there to the 1,000 mark. We're slowly getting, but we will get there. I assure you. Hopefully by this year. Okay. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.